coming up on the AFN Europe Report.
It's the end of the road for some North Carolina National Guardsmen in Iraq. Plus, we go airborne in Africa. See what happens when two nations hit the skies. And it's the little things that make a big difference for airmen in Turkey.
That and more. The AFN Europe Report starts now.
Good evening and thanks for joining us. I'm Army Sergeant Dijon Rolle. It's been a long, hard road, literally, for many soldiers serving in Iraq. Army Sergeant Eric Shadowins is with the engineers as they complete one of their last reconstruction projects before redeploying.
Today, the North Carolina National Guard soldiers work on their last big project of their deployment. An access road connecting Forward Operating Base Sykes to the city of Talifar.
As we're doing a service to the community by giving them a roadway that's safe to travel.
Heavy track vehicles like tanks and Bradleys have damaged the road over time, causing it to become bumpy and difficult to drive on. The engineers are removing 4 kilometers of broken, rutted asphalt while creating a 50-foot-wide two-lane dirt road. They work long hours under some difficult conditions.
The space is very limited, so and it also gets really, really hot in there.
The kids, it's a constant challenge keeping their safety ensured as well as ours.
The engineers provide their own security while working outside the safety and security of the base. They constantly keep an eye out for anyone or anything that wishes to do them harm.
Our first and foremost goal is to protect the soldiers.
While at the same time continuing their work and helping to keep traffic moving.
They've done an outstanding job through the constant dangerous missions we've had.
Army Sergeant Eric Shadowins, Talifar, Iraq.
Navigating the waters isn't just for the Navy. The Army has a unique mission that puts them on boats as well. Airman Troy Davis is with the group as they pull into port to take care of business.
This definitely isn't something you see every day. A small crew of Army soldiers in a boat at Lodges. But they did show up with a purpose.
This was for rations, for fuel, any maintenance that needed to be done, and just to take a little bit of a break. We had to wait a little bit for weather also before we headed out.
These sailing soldiers stationed at Fort Eustis, Virginia, are returning from a 2-month trip in England. The stopover on Tercera Island gave airmen and families a chance to tour the Army tugboat and meet the crew, not to mention highlighting the support capabilities of Lodges airmen.
Here at Lodges, we get a lot of transient aircraft and things that come through. This is kind of different since we have an actual ship coming through, and we have to change, we have a jet fuel truck, we got to convert it over to diesel, and which is a kind of a big process.
And whether it's aircraft heading to the fight or ships headed for home, they always know Lodges Field is here to support them. Airman First Class Troy Davis, Lodges Field, Azores.
Now after leaving Lodges, the crew is making the 10-day voyage back to their home of Fort Eustis, Virginia. Teamwork is always important for a successful mission, whether it's right here at home or thousands of miles away. Air Force Sergeant Laura Holzer takes to the skies of Africa to train with troops, learning this lesson firsthand.
In a joint combined environment, communication is important.
Petit. Have safe jump.
Especially when 100 Malian Defense Force troops are about to jump from another country's aircraft using another country's equipment. Communication is key from the air crew to the instructors to the students, which can be difficult when you don't speak the same language.
It's all hands-on training, so pretty much so as you can, as you move with them, they move with you. So it's really not a language barrier, but it does assist, of course, in the cooperation of the jumper.
Yeah, it's a very positive cooperation. We've been involved here the last 2 years. They provide a great venue for us and continue to understand the environmental challenges of the Trans-Sahara, which of course supports an understanding of the some of the austere regions of the global war on terrorism.
Although this landing zone isn't as austere as some would like.
Yeah, I was trying to avoid some of these lava rocks out here too, so.
Our manner of training is not the same, but I'm happy to have something from United States.
Congratulations, airborne. With the training complete, these troops are exchanging their jump wing.
And a simple phrase can sum up their appreciation.
Merci, mon colonel.
Merci beaucoup.
Staff Sergeant Laurel Holzer, Bamako, Mali.
Cutbacks are coming as one military service works to slash its numbers. Air Force Sergeant Sumoy Ruiz has more on the effects of force shaping.
Spangdahlem's Mission Support Squadron wants to get the word out to you. The Air Force has too many people. In the next few years, our total number of airmen will drop to just 300,000. 19,000 airmen will face separation, early retirement, or crossing over from blue to green to join the Army. A career in the Air Force may not be an option.
Folks who probably planned on having careers in the Air Force are probably going to meet the reality that their Air Force careers may be shortened, you know, and then for a lot of officers, it could be a good thing. There are officers out there who really planned on leaving the Air Force between that identified time. Something that we feel will be beneficial to the Air Force down the line, and it's something that we support and we will do.
The Air Force hopes to have all force shaping efforts completed by 2011. Staff Sergeant Sumoy Ruiz, Spangdahlem Air Base, Germany.
Don't forget, you can also look us up on the web. The address is there on your screen. We're at afneurope.net. Now, all the stories you see on the AFN Europe Report are available on our website. Now, if it's a story you'd like to share, you can save it to your computer and email the story to anyone you like. But up next, it can be tough being the new kid. See how service members in Italy are making new troops feel right at home. When the AFN Europe Report continues after this, stay with us.
Army Field Support Brigade Europe, the Army's first expeditionary logistics brigade. Formed in November 2004 and already on the ground in Iraq and Afghanistan. 1,600 people, soldiers and civilians, Americans and our European allies, pushing readiness power forward to the battlefield. Whether it's repairing vehicles and equipment for fighting units or providing expert assistance, AFSBE is the Army's readiness bridgehead in Europe.
Welcome back. Now, whether you're starting fresh or finishing up, earning a degree can be a challenge as a service member. Now, add to that the daily responsibilities of work and family. Airman Rob Joswiak has some help for those seeking higher education.
Terry, the tests allow for people to gain college credit for knowledge they already have. The system helps speed up the process of gaining a degree.
It's a big advantage. I've clept a number of classes and I've passed a number of these CLEPS tests, so all it takes is an hour of your time and, you know, save yourself the hassle of going to classes.
The tests are pass or fail, so they do not affect a person's GPA.
Try testing. You know, it's free to use, active duty especially. Take it with the attitude, if you get credit, do something good for yourself. Celebrate big and go to Paris or go to Rome. If you don't get it, don't worry about it.
Getting credit for a class does not necessarily mean taking a class for 8 weeks, but in this case, it can be as simple as one exam. Airman First Class Rob Joswiak, Ramstein Air Base, Germany.
Watch it in here. These are the areas that they're...
Moving to a new duty station can be stressful for military members and their families. It's hard to know where to go for all the answers amid a sea of questions. Next, we head to our AFN South Bureau, where Specialist Katrina Nichols has a story about troops making sure it's smooth sailing for newcomers. All right, Katrina.
Thanks, Sergeant Rolle. Having a sponsor can make a big difference to new arrivals. But being a good sponsor doesn't happen by accident. Petty Officer Elijah Lennar shows us how normal sailors must train to become great sponsors.
Arriving at a new duty station can be difficult. That's when a command sponsor becomes really essential. The command sponsorship program is designed to help sailors and their families to prepare for a new duty station transition and adjust to their new environment. EOD command sponsor Petty Officer 2nd Class Nicodemo Abagon says he hopes his sponsoree feels as good as he did when he arrived in Sigonella.
My first feeling was excitement, and I was hoping that my sponsor would be able to show me everything I wanted to see, and sure enough, he was able to. Hopefully, he'll feel the same way I did when I first got here, pretty much welcomed.
Sailors need to take the command-based sponsorship course and the Navy Knowledge Online e-learning sponsorship course in order to be a command sponsor. Ideally, a command matches a sailor to the incoming sponsoree. This is to ensure that the sponsor is well experienced with the procedures that their new check-in needs to complete and can better prepare them for the transition. The idea is that a new member who is adequately informed and genuinely welcomed will be a better adjusted and more productive member of the command. Being a sponsor is a great responsibility that requires research, time, and some creativity. Sponsorship course instructor Petty Officer First Class Mark Swarski says, to be a sponsor requires a lot of involvement.
That's their first contact. That's the first thing they're going to see for the Navy and Sigonella, for their command, for the island here, and the community. Sponsorship program here, you have to be involved for it to work.
A good sponsor can make a big difference during transition to a new duty station. And as the old saying goes, you don't get a second chance to make a first impression. Petty Officer Elijah Lenar, AFN, Sigonella, Italy.
Sponsors are responsible for helping sailors through in-processing and researching information that is helpful for the sailor and his family's needs. For the AFN Europe Report, I'm Specialist Katrina Nichols. Now back to you in Mannheim.
It's time now for some of our AFN stations to break away with their own local programming. But before you go, make sure you check us out on the web. Our address is www.afneurope.net, and there you can see any of the stories or anything else that went on that you may have missed in tonight's newscast. But if you're staying with us, it's the little things that make a big difference for some airmen in Turkey. That story up next. Don't go away.
The U.S. Army Criminal Investigation Command is offering a 5,000 euro reward for information leading to the recovery of a stolen vehicle. The vehicle is a government-owned, high-mobility, multi-purpose wheeled vehicle and was last seen in Schifferstadt, Germany. The bumper number is 596-MT-171/3. If you have any information regarding this vehicle, please contact the Mannheim CID at DSN 385-3606. That's 385-3606.
Look out for your friends when it's time to party. Let the bartender know at any participating MWR facility that you're the designated driver, and you'll receive a wristband for free coffee and colas all evening. The facilities are close, convenient, and a great place to relax. Your friends can drink without worrying, and when the night is over, you'll be there to take charge. Be a true friend. Be the designated driver.
Welcome back. It can be as simple as stocking a snack machine or repairing dozens of washing machines. No matter how small the effort may seem, it all adds up to big improvements for service members' quality of life. Airman Tom Kennedy goes inside Angelic's base housing.
These laundry rooms are getting a facelift. Over the next few months, contractors at Angelic Air Base will repair and renovate all the dorm laundry rooms on base. The goal is to increase the efficiency and appearance of the dorm facilities.
Of course, everyone will benefit. They'll have better facilities. Hopefully, we'll get the money to buy new equipment. It's a win-win situation for the dorm occupants.
Dorm residents will have to travel to other dorms during the renovations, but a little inconvenience now will pay off in the long run.
This is what I strive for. This is what we fight for every year, to get money to improve the quality of life of our personnel. And when it does happen, there is no better satisfaction. The overriding intent here is to improve the quality of life.
The laundry room renovation is just one way the housing office is continually improving quality of life base-wide. Airman Tom Kennedy, Interlik Air Base, Turkey.
If you have a story idea, we'd love to hear from you. Just email us. The address is news@afne.army.mil. Whether it's a question, comment, or concern, you can always hit us up at that address. Now remember, news@afne.army.mil. And you can also look us up on the web. The address is there on your screen. We're at afneurope.net. Now, all the stories you see on tonight's newscast are available on our website. Now, if it's a story you'd like to share, you can save it to your computer and email the story to anyone you like. That's all the time we have for tonight. For everyone here at the AFN Europe Report, good night.